大多故事是由嚼通天海鲜酒家特约赞助播出。加拿大华人社区人士不久前致信联邦政府，引用来自加拿大传媒基金官方网站的统计数据，问询和质疑在前联邦保守党政府执政期间，加拿大传媒基金在2010至2015年间多次为加拿大独一家中文电视台及其制作公司播出超过50%以上每年拨给全家少数族裔的传媒基金，所有项目累计总金额近1700万元，就此要求联邦政府对此事进行调查和解释，希望宝贵的加拿大社区资源能够有一个平衡平等的分配和负责使用。加拿大传媒基金是由联邦政府2010年创立的非牟利机构，用于扶持开发资助并推广加拿大本土国产内容的广播电视媒体。华人社区人士质疑，在社会平等价值观的加拿大，全国从事少数族裔语种的传媒数不胜数，仅华社媒体精英无数，为什么就一家电视台可以数年连续获得数百万元的资金扶持运行？
This is of interest to for the media community, but also for the community in general as well. We just want your attention as Thomas and Francis mentioned already, from the community and also our media friends, that this is something unusual, it's special. So it was attention, just like many issues may have brought your attention of the SECM over the years, like whether it's about the Chinese signage, about Hill Bell many years ago, deputy mayor issues, and many other things. Community members sometimes address certain concerns, and as responsible community leaders and also Canadians in general, we are responsible to look at and also evaluate the situation. So to bring the attention to everyone, in particular the media, if it's a certain value. And in this particular case, it's certainly of great interest to the media, I'm sure, and particularly the ethnic media community. But more importantly, also for the community at large, because that's important. The fact that the multicultural community are the ones that will be beneficial from actually having the diverse language programs that's given in Canada for the families, or also for communication with each other, and also communication with overseas in other areas as well. So it's important for us to know that there's support from the government. The government support the community for all the different programs, which comes from, of course, the taxpayers' money, which means from all Canadians as well, and all, whether they are paying the tax to the residential or investments or business as well. So we're all part of that, should be all part of the beneficiary as well too. So with this, so it has been addressed to us to look in this unusual pattern that was brought up, and the fact that more than a significant amount, which is very unusual in funding. The CMF, as mentioned, is a actually entity, is created by the government. It's an arm in terms of, just like Ontario Children Foundation and many other, but in addition, also revenue generated from also like from the lodgers and the cable, for the income from the revenue of that certain portion, they have to contribute back along with the funding from the government. So each year there's a significant amount of money that's used for the different programs. And majority programs are given to the mainstreams, naturally, the French, English, and there are regional programs. But there's a small portion is for the especially earmarked to the diverse language program, which is a very small portion. But out of that small portion, it's roughly around $2.5 million a year. So that still is not a large amount, but a significant amount for many of the ethnic community that can generate a fund to use. Normally in the process, the government will be, as many of you already applied for fundings or working with the government, there's a process, there's a call from the government for actual submission of proposals, or they have programs that you apply for funding on the site. In this case, there's obviously there's a site in there that you can apply. And unfortunately, probably most of you, and many of you, might not know about this fund, which is one of the issues that was one of concern that the government did not really have a chance to, or did not want to propose this to the community at large and notifying that such funds exist for the diverse communities.
Yeah, my name is David Pupalapilai. It's Pupalapilai. I'm from the Canadian Tamil Congress. I'm the national spokesperson for Canadian Tamil Congress.
And what reason brought you here and why CMF issue concerns you?
Yeah, we do work closely with FCM, Federation of Canadian Chinese, and I know Dr. Ng and other leadership quite well. So when they contacted us recently, when they brought up this matter to us, we were quite shocked. So any government funding, Jamie, in Canada or in Ontario, anywhere, it should be done on an equitable basis. You know, if there is a media funding, every media should be informed. That's where proper procedure should be in place. Everybody should have the opportunity to be applied, and there should be a transparent procedure should be in place, must be in place. But this was not followed when it comes to this funding. A particular organization got this amount of money without any proper procedure, we were told. It is not right. So we were quite shocked as an organization, as a community, and so that's the reason we are partnering with other organizations to make sure in future, if any funding like this, not only a media funding, any funding like this, if the government comes forward and grants any funding, there should be a proper procedure should be in place, transparency should be maintained, and it should be given on an equitable basis, and everybody should benefit it. So in other words, Chinese media like yours, all media should be given a chance. If you're qualified, you get it. If you're not qualified, that doesn't matter. It's a different story, but that was not followed. So we are quite shocked, and in future we are ready to work with you and work with the Chinese Canadian and any other Canadian community to make sure there should be a proper procedure in place.
感谢收看今天的大豆故事，我们下期再见。